Hallo. Hello, Boker Tov. Are we ready?
Yes.
Okay, so I just want to make sure that everybody that I have today are the people that I had last time. Is there somebody new today that wasn't here last time on Sunday? Okay, so everybody was here. So, okay, great. Do you have any questions?
Yes.
Okay.
I have a couple. Can you hear me
all right? Yeah, we can hear you all right.
Okay. There was two vowels with one was horizontal, and the next one was that with a line going vertical, like a T. They both sound the same. Why is there two different vowels?
Okay, so there is actually going to be a third one that will sound the same, but okay, so in Hebrew there are five sounds of vowels: a, e, e, o, and u. So a sounds the same and it is a long a. So you're absolutely right. So let me show you this. Just a second, we'll go there. All right. So let me share my screen. This vowel, like the last time we learned the letter bet, when we put the a, this one, it's ba, right? So you write that this is an a. And then if we go here, it's the same thing. This is a and this is ba. They're exactly the same thing. There are rules of vocalization that sometimes we have to put this vowel a and sometimes we have to put the other one. It has to do with the syllables in Hebrew and the rules. However, these are very complicated rules, and most even Israelis do not know all the rules, because when we begin learning how to read, let's say first grade, we read with vowels. When we get to second grade, no more vowels. So even the Israelis do not put a lot of time and effort understanding all the rules. Because we begin, and I think I told you this last time, we begin reading context and not necessarily words. And that's how we make sense of what the word mean. For the purpose of our class, you really do not need to know all the rules. There is no need for you to know them. To be honest with you, I know some of the rules, but sometimes even I make mistakes. I do not know all the rules very, very well. So when you read for in the prayer book and when you read in our class, you just need to know that when you see the line, it's A, and when you see that small T, it's also A. That's all you need to know.
Okay.
Yeah.
I got that second question, if I can, whenever.
Sure, go ahead.
I'm not quite sure I understand this Shoresh. Am I pronouncing that correctly? Shoresh.
Right. Shoresh, right. Shoresh is root. And I'm glad you're bringing it up, because we're going to talk about a Shoresh today some more. So the Shoresh, it consists of three letters, okay? And if you know the Shoresh, if you know the Shoresh, then you have a better understanding when you see variation or different patterns with it. So here, since we're talking about it, if you don't mind, but let me just put, anybody else has any other question before we go into Shoresh? Because that was actually part of my lesson today. So does anybody have any other questions? Okay, so I'm gonna get to the Shoresh. Is there somebody that was not here last time? Because I see more people joining. I just wanna make sure that everybody, okay. The other thing that I wanna say is that the recording, Kate, I'll get to you in a minute. The recording actually, we're gonna upload it this Tuesday, because it was on my computer. And I tried to send the file over here so that we can upload it. And it's too large of a file. So I have to, so this week I'm gonna bring my laptop and then we're gonna upload it. So that's what we're gonna do. Kate, what is your question?
Oh, I was just raising my hand because you asked if anyone was here that wasn't here last time.
Okay, so you were not here last time. So what I recommend that you do is hopefully the recording will be up on Tuesday, but all of you can still go to the Bethel YouTube channel and there are some recording from previous years that you can actually even view, but the recording will be here on Tuesday. And then I recommend that you watch it. And then if you have any questions or you need to meet with me, I'll be more than happy to do that. Okay?
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. So let me, first of all, do this. So the letters that we learned last time, does anybody remember? What were they?
Shin, bat, and tav.
Shin, bet, and tav, right? So we learned shin, which has the sh sound, sh sound, bet, which has the b sound. And remember, the name of the letter gives you the sound of the letter. So shin, sh, bet, b. Tav, T, right? With or without the dot, it's a T. We also learned that this vowel is A and this vowel is A. So that we, and then we got to
we went over these letters last time. So let me make it a little bit bigger. So anybody remembers this letter? What is it?
La.
Uh-huh. So la is the sound of it, or lamed, right? L. That's the L sound. Sorry. Okay. Where is, I hope I have over here, the way that I can write. Oh yeah, I can. All right, so this is the L sound, right? And this letter is, anybody remembers the sound of it?
Dalet.
Dalet, right. This has the D sound, right? And then we have this letter, which has, what's the sound of it?
No.
M, has the M sound. And then we have a final letter. Final letter will always be at the end of a word. So the final mem will be at the end of a word. Okay, so this still has the M sound, but this mem will be in the beginning or the middle of a word, and this one will be at the end of a word. Okay? All right, now we're learning two new vowels. One dot is the E vowel. So now you need to remember that one vowel, one dot is E. And this vowel with this letter and the dot on the top. So the dot on top, on, it's an O sound. So this is an E sound, O sound. These two dots are silent. They're there, but they don't mean anything. It's like it's not there. Okay? So we will practice with it. So we'll get to here. So what is this letter here? What's the sound of it? Right, L, the L sound, right? So when I have this vowel, this will be what?
La.
La, right. Now, the letter hey over here, hey, is silent. So this is la, and also this is la.
La.
They're both la. Okay. So Jeremy, read line one.
Should be la.
No, it's on page, yeah, nine, line one. Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, yeah. It should be la.
Uh-huh.
La. And then it's still la.
Very good.
La.
Mm-hmm.
La. Is it Lashen or Lasha?
Lash, because there is no vowel here, so it would be Lash.
Lash. All right. Uh-huh. And then La.
Okay, page number two.
La. Bal.
Mm-hmm.
But,
mm-hmm.
La, tal,
mm-hmm.
Bal,
uh-huh.
La.
Very good. All right, Vicky, number three. Oh, by the way, like I said before, if you do not wish to read, you don't have to. I mean, just let me know. I'm just calling on your names. So go ahead, Vicky, number three.
Shala,
mm-hmm.
Lasha. Tabat.
Very good. Taba. Very good.
Oh, taba. Ba. Ta.
Mm-hmm.
La la. La.
Okay, excellent. Russell, number four.
La ba. La bash.
That's not it.
Babal,
mm-hmm.
Bashal, Babash.
Okay, very good. Grace?
I don't think it's on.
Okay, Kelly.
All right, which one am I doing?
Five.
Lala, Shala, Shabal, Shabbat, and Shabal. And no, Shatal.
Okay, very good. All right. Are you all good? Yes. Any questions? All right. So the next thing I want to talk about is the lulav. Lulav over here. You would probably hear it pronounced lulav, but it's lulav. Have you heard of lulav? Does anybody know which holiday we use the lulav? We actually just used it recently.
Sukkot,
right. So Sukkot is the holiday, we can say booth. Sukkah is actually the booth, the sukkah. Lulav is the very top branch, at the top of a palm tree. And the palm tree is actually the date tree, not the coconut tree, but the date tree, because desert-like weather has more palm trees. So lulav. And on Sukkot, we have these four species, and the lulav is one of them. And we put it together because we are all one. We put all these four species together as one, and we shake it all around to show that God is everywhere. So that's the lulav. The other word that I want you to remember here is lechem, which is bread, because there is a blessing for the bread. When before we eat any meal that there is bread, we say hamotzi lechem min haaretz. So the word lechem means bread. All right, let's move on. Okay, so now this vowel is O. So now this would be low, and this is also low. So Aleph, the letter Aleph and the letter Hey, if they have no vowels, they're silent, okay? So let me go back in here for a minute, because I know I'm going too fast with these letters. So let's look at the letters for a minute. So this is the letter. It's the first Hebrew letter. What is it?
Aleph.
Aleph. Very good. And we learned this letter, which is Bet. Okay. We also learned this one now, Dalet. Now, and this letter is Hey. So Aleph and Hey are silent letters if they have no vowels, which means the letter Aleph will have a sound only if it has the vowel of a, e, I, o, u. Otherwise, it's just there. Aleph. Hey, at the end of a word, most times hey comes at the end of a word and it has no sound to it. It's silent. Okay? But if it does have a vowel, it will be ha, he, he, ho, and who. It has the H sound if it has a vowel, okay? So Aleph and Hey, when they have no vowel, they're silent, okay? Am I going too fast? Am I clear? Good? Everything is good? Okay. So over here, what you need to remember that this would be mark. What is this right here? Okay, Ashlyn?
Oh, sorry, low.
Okay, low, and this is also?
Low.
Uh-huh, okay, so read line one.
Oh, you're on a different page. Okay, low, low. Bow,
mm-hmm.
bo, show, toe, low.
Very good. Okay. Number two, Ashlyn.
Bow, low, show, low, toe, bow, toe.
Okay, Gregory?
This is my first class, so I'm gonna.
Okay, all right, that's fine. Yeah. So, okay, no problem. Ron, number three.
Bow, slow, bow, low, bow, low, low.
Okay, so Gregory and Kate, are you guys okay? How are you doing?
Just soaking it up right now. I'll catch up on the video and the lessons.
Yeah. All right. So the important thing to know is, first of all, this letter has the sound of what?
L.
The sound of L, right? So with this vowel, this would be
la.
La, and this is also
la.
And this is also
la.
So the important thing to know that this letter hey and the letter aleph are silent. If you want to write hey and aleph for you, so hey, you would write it like this line going down and here. This is hey. And I do recommend that you practice writing these letters because there is a connection between actually writing them and remembering them. So this is the letter hey. And this is how we write Aleph. So if you look at the way you see the print, it's always more filled in. But when we write it more like stick figures. Okay? We write more like stick figures. It's a lot easier. Okay, so line five, is there anybody that did not read that I missed last time? Anybody that did not read that would like to read? You can just raise your hand if you want to. If not, I'll go down the list again. All right. Russell, number five.
We have la, 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 bo, ta, sho.
Kelly, number six.
Ba, bat, sha, sho, to, la.
Page seven.
Ta, to, tal, to, bo, ba.
Very good. Excellent. Okay. Everybody really, really good. Eight, Jeremy.
Is it laba?
Labo, because this vowel is long. Labo.
And then shaba for shabash.
Very good.
And then that is tabal.
Mm-hmm.
And then that's bow.
Mm-hmm.
And then it should be la again.
The vowel is O, so it will be?
Low.
Okay, very good. All right, so now we have the letter mem, which is M. But do you remember what this is? What's this one right here?
D.
It's a mem sophit.
Mem sophit, the final one. So it will always be at the end of a word. So if you look, you see in here, this is the final mem over here, whereas the mem would be either at the beginning or in the middle of a word, right? So let's talk about these words. Matzah, does anybody know what matzah is? When do we eat matzah? Anybody knows?
Passover.
Yeah, Passover, right. And you know the reason why we eat matzah?
Isn't it unleavened grain?
Yeah. So the people of Israel, when they left Egypt, they did not have time for the bread to rise because they had to leave in a hurry. So that's why we eat the matzah. It is unleavened bread. So in order for the matzah not to rise, actually, it has to be done from beginning till the end within 18 minutes so that it doesn't rise. Okay? 18 minutes. The next thing is, does anybody know what this is?
Mezuzah.
Mezuzah, right. So the commandment for the mezuzah, to put it on our doorpost, is actually in a prayer that's called Vahafta, and it is in the book of Deuteronomy. And the prayer says, and you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, and with all your soul. And then God is asking us to put it on our doorpost. Okay. So when you look at the mezuzah, the house of the mezuzah is not really that important. I mean, it's just a decorative thing. It's what's inside the mezuzah that is important. And there is a scroll. And the scroll has the prayer, the Shema Israel and the Vahafta together. It's right there. It's actually written by hand. So there is a scribe that writes it by hand using, again, just like you write the Torah, you would write a scroll that is inside the mezuzah. So when we walk in the house, we need to acknowledge and remember the love of God. We walk in the house, when we leave, it's the same thing. That's why we have the mezuzah there. Okay, and then the last thing, I don't know if you would know what that is called Megillah or Megillah. I don't know if you've heard the word Megillah. So Megillah or Megillah is a scroll also. And we read it during the holiday of Purim. So the Megillah is actually the book of Esther. And normally we celebrate the holiday of Purim during March. And we are, again, commanded to read the Megillah. And it is the book of Esther. And what it is about is the people of Israel were in Persia, and there was this minister that wanted to kill all the people, his name was Haman. And he actually drew lots, a lottery on the date that he was going to kill all the Jewish people. And then Esther became the queen, and Esther saved the people, her, you know, the Jewish people. This actually happened in Persia. If you look up online, the graves of Esther and Mordechai, who was her uncle, are still in Isfahan in Iran. So it's still there. Okay. So that's the Megillah. So I recommend that you read the book of Esther. It's actually, Purim is a fun holiday. It's very similar like Halloween. You know, we have Halloween coming up tomorrow. In Purim, we dress up, you know, and it's a fun. And the reason why we dress up is because our fate changed. We were not killed, we survived. And that's why we dress up. So that's the reason for that. Okay? All right, so let's read line one. Grace, do you wanna do line one? Okay, Ashlyn, line one.
Matt.
No, the hey is silent, so it would be ma.
Oh, ma, mo. Ma, mo.
Okay, very good. Number two, Vicky?
Loam,
mm-hmm.
Bom,
mm-hmm.
Shom, Tom,
Tom.
Shom, oh, sorry, Tom, Shom, Bom, Bom, Shom, sorry, Shom.
Okay, very, very good. All right. Ron, number three.
Shal, Mashal, Shamash, Balam, Tom, Bam.
Okay, very good. Am I missing? Let's see. Mark, number four.
Is it Lama?
Mm-hmm.
Mashim?
No, Ma.
Ma.
Ma mash.
Ma mash. Ma mash.
Ma mash.
Sha. Shaba. Shaba.
Mm-hmm.
And Bala.
Okay, very good. All right, what's this word over here? What is it? Shalom. Uh-huh, shalom. What is shalom?
Hello, goodbye.
Okay. So this is the root of shalom. Shin, lamed, and mem. Okay. So the word shalom means, we say it's high bite and peace, but it also has a deeper meaning to it, which means peace, complete, whole. That's what it means. To be whole, complete, and peaceful. All right. So I want to show you something. So Ron, now I'm responding to your question. Why is it important to know the root? So when I know the root, I am more likely to understand what the word means. And I'm going to show you the word shalom in Hebrew is a very important word. We have shalom means peace. Shalom is built on the root shin lamed mem. So words that built on the root shin lamed mem have peace, harmony, completeness, and wholeness as part of the meaning. So when I say shalom, I'm not just saying hi or bye. I'm actually saying you to have peace, right? Kind of like thinking about your peace level. But I want to show you the connection of shalom. The city of peace is called Yerushalayim, Jerusalem. Yerushalayim, in the name Yerushalayim, Jerusalem, has the root of Shin, Lamed, and Mem. And that's why it's called the city of peace. Okay. So if you think about Yerushalayim, Jerusalem, it is a city of peace because there are three religions that all pray together. Christians, Muslims, and Jews, right, at the same time, okay, at that moment. Now, of course, there is a lot of tensions about it, I mean, in other ways, but in actuality, the reason why it is the city of peace is that it brings everybody together and everybody prays at the same time. So, Yerushalayim. Now, the king that built you Yerushalayim is King Solomon. In his name, Shlomo, there is Shin Lamed Mem. He was the king of peace. At the time when he reigned, there was actually complete peace on Israel. So that's why he was called the king of peace. So if you look at the root and you understand the root, you're more likely to understand what the meaning of words are. So Hebrew, sometimes if you think about words and the roots in Hebrew, it does have a deeper meaning than what the word looks like. So if you think about the word shalom, yeah, hi, bye. It doesn't have, you know, you don't look at it this way, but it does have a deeper meaning to it. In the book, in our book, and I'm going to go to the book and I'm going to show you this. And I don't expect you to remember the words because, so in Hebrew, when I ask you, how are you? Mashlomcha or mashlomech. If you look at the root of mashlomcha, shin lamed mem, I'm actually asking what is your peace level. That's the deeper meaning. So I'm not just asking how are you. I'm asking what's your peace level like. And then the word Jerusalem, we talked about it, is the city of peace. Okay. In here it says, what an irony, in times of tension and division, the city is far from being whole and complete. Yet such integrity is the ideal. And I did experience a moment of that was ideal when I was in Jerusalem. So it was nighttime. I think maybe it was 8 or 9 o'clock. It was dark, but you know, where the Western Wall is, it's that area is well lit. This, and so when I was actually standing up, looking down at the Western Wall, and at that moment, and I swear to God, that was really an ideal moment. I heard Jews praying. I heard the bells of the church from the church there, the Holy Sepulchre Church. And then at the same time, the Muslims were praying and they were going, Allahu Akbar, at the same time. So at that moment, it did seem like everybody came together at that moment that when I was there. It was a very, very spiritual moment for me when I was there. So there are some moments that I think that there is, we can experience Jerusalem as a city of peace, even though it is kind of ironic at the moment. All right, any questions about the root now? Any questions about root and understanding roots? Go ahead.
Yeah, I do. Is there an unlimited amount of these, or are there just certain? I mean, how many of these do we have to learn? I mean,
so actually, every word in Hebrew has a root to it. They all have roots. It's a root system, and based on the root system, we have patterns that we built, and the pattern will be for verbs, adjectives, and adverbs. The same like English. A way to think about it, maybe to make it easier, like let's say you have the word agree, right? So you have agreement, agreeable, agreeing, agreed. It's all kind of like the same, right? So the same thing in Hebrew. You have the root, shin, lamed, mem, and from you know that it means peace, whole, complete. When you look at words, it makes it a little bit easier for you to know what the meaning of the word is. But you don't, sometimes it's very hard because the pattern can make it a little bit more difficult. But in the prayer book, in our prayer book, there are certain words that are very repetitive. And if you know the roots of those words, it makes it easier to know what the meaning of words. So let's say love. The root of love appears a lot in the prayer book because we talk about us loving God. God loves us. So love is one of those roots. Holy, the root of holy is a repetitive root. Holiness, holy, sanctify, all of that. So there are certain roots that you will see them over and over and over again in the prayers. And we will talk about them. Okay, any other questions about roots? All right, so I do want you to remember, what I want you to remember is if you see the root Shin Lamed Mem, these three letters, remember that it means whole, complete, and peaceful. So just for you to remember it. Okay, so are we ready to move on or do you have any questions? Okay, so now we're gonna look at the new vowel. And this vowel is, do you remember what it is? E. It is a long E, but a way that I'm asking you to remember it is if you think about the letter I that has a dot at the top, that dot. So that's E, and this is E. Maybe that will help you remember that the one dot is E. Okay, so this would be she, me, B, T, Lee. Okay?
She, me, B.
T, Lee. She, me, B, T, Lee. So we learned actually three vowels, A, O, and now we're learning E. Okay, now look at this letter here, right here. This is the letter Yud. Yud is like Y. However, when it is at the end of a word, it's silent. So we learned three silent letters. What are they? What are the three silent letters that we learn?
Aleph and Hey.
Aleph, Hey, and now Yud. The Yud together with the vowel E is silent. Only with the vowel E is silent. So this would be she, me, be, ti, li. So with the Yud or without the Yud, it's still the E. So look in here. This would be she, me, be, ti, li. It's the same. But the Yud is silent here. So it's like it's not there, but it's there, right? Okay, any questions about on the vowel E, the sound E? So now when you look, okay, so remember when you read, look at the letter and then look at the vowel. If you see one dot now, you need to remember that it is what?
E.
E, very good. All right. Okay, so Vicky, do you want to read line one?
Sure. Is that he? No, sorry, me.
Me, very good.
Be he?
B-T.
No, B-T.
Mm-hmm.
Me. Me?
Mm-hmm.
Me? Sean?
Mm-hmm.
Me?
Okay, very good. Ron, number two.
Beam, bomb,
mm-hmm.
she, shim, shalosh, bima, balash.
Okay, very good. All right, Russell, three.
Mitot,
mm-hmm.
Bila, Libi, Mila, Bimat,
mm-hmm.
Bat, Lama.
Very good. And Kelly, four.
Bama, Bamot, Biti, Shema, Bimot. Balash and Bash or Tash.
Tom.
Okay.
To me.
All right. Okay. Ashlyn, five.
Shaw. Lash.
Lashot.
Ashot. Lim Mot.
Mm-hmm.
Meal.
Very good.
Well. Shamash.
Mm-hmm.
Shaba.
Mm-hmm.
Shlow.
Okay. So when we say, very good. When we say Shabbat Shalom, what are we saying? Shabbat Shalom. Have you heard the term Shabbat Shalom?
Happy Friday, have a peaceful Shabbat.
Yes, to have a peaceful Shabbat, exactly. We wish each other to have a peaceful Shabbat.
Hey, Dina.
Yes?
Can you go back to that page and circle the things that we read that were actual words? Like, I know we had Shabbat Shalom. And then did we talk about Bima yesterday?
We did talk about Bima yesterday, and I showed everybody it's like the stage and it's a word. Yeah, in the synagogue, the Bima is where we go up. That's that stage, the Bima.
Right.
And was it? Shalosh is a number three. Bat, you know, when we say bat mitzvah, have you heard of that? Bat.
Yeah.
Bat means daughter. Daughter of commandment. Bat mitzvah means daughter of commandment.
So I'm glad you said that, because I always keep thinking girl, but daughter is different than girl. Mm-hmm. So I'm glad you said that one.
Yeah. And we have Shamash. That's also, you know, in Hanukkah,
mm-hmm.
we have the Shamash, the candle, it's called the candle helper, the one that helps light the other candles. So that's a Shamash. Some of these words, Shishim is 60, Tami is a name. So some of them do have meaning, some of them don't in these words. But the word Shamash and Bima, these are words that you will need to know. And Bat, these are words that you will probably need to know. Okay, what is this letter right here?
Dalet.
Dalet, which has the D sound. D sound. Okay. And then this would be what?
Do.
Do, and this is also?
Do.
Do, so the dot doesn't make a difference. The dot doesn't change the sound of it. This is do and this is do, okay? Line one, Jeremy?
Yes, should be do. Da.
Mm-hmm.
And then do again.
Look at the vowel.
Da.
Mm-hmm.
Do.
Look at the vowel.
It's da again.
No, it's one dot. So one dot is.
Oh, it's do.
D.
D.
One dot is D, uh-huh.
Okay, and then, is it do?
Mm-hmm, this one is do, very good.
Okay. And then, that is do, or is it da?
One dot is Z, so it will be D.
D.
Uh-huh.
And then da.
Mm-hmm.
And then, oh man,
mm-hmm.
is it, I don't know.
It would be do.
Okay, thank you.
So let's review it again. So the important thing to remember is the vowel now. So now you have to pay attention because it's the same letter over and over and over again, but now we have to look at the vowel. So that T vowel here, I cannot circle it very well. And this one here, they're both what? What's the sound of it?
Ah.
Ah. All right. One dot, right here, the one dot, that would be always what?
E.
E, very good. And then this vowel here, that when the dot is on top, it will be O. Okay. So again, so this is A-A-E-O-E-A-O. Did I go too fast? Okay, let me do it again. I'm just doing the vowels, the sounds of the vowels. I'm not doing the letters right now. A, A, E, O, E, A, O. Okay?
I have one quick question. This may be because I missed the first class, but the last ah you said, the second to last word.
Yeah, this one, that little line.
Yeah, but then the first two are the T-shaped vowels and they're ah as well, right?
So both of them, this is ah, and this is ah.
So why the difference?
Okay. So there is a reason why. There is a reason why sometimes we do this and sometimes we do that. There is. There are actually vocalization rules. But as I said before, most Israelis don't even know all the rules. I mean, you have to spend a lot of time learning all the rules and understanding all the rules. I mean, we know them. It's not that we don't know them, but the way we learn how to read Hebrew, the way Hebrew is structured, is that when we begin learning Hebrew, we read Hebrew with vowels. But then we remove the vowels and we start reading without vowels. So when you're going to go to synagogue, the prayer book always has vowels, but the Torah doesn't have vowels. And the way we learn how to read is we do not read words, we read context of words. So I talked to the students last time and I said that in a way, we're the most literate people. And I don't mean literate just because of literacy rate, but the way we read Hebrew is we don't read words, we have to read context. We need to know the entire sentence for us to be able to know how to pronounce the vowels. And that is at a much higher level. What for now, for the purpose of our class and what you're going to need to be doing, let's say in the synagogue, you know, when you're going to read the prayers, you're just going to need to know that this is the vowel ah, and this is the vowel ah, and this is the vowel e, and this is the vowel o. That's all you're going to need to know.
Okay.
But not necessarily all the rules. Okay, so let me see where we're at now here. Oh, I went all the way to the end of the book. Shoot. Sorry. Because I wanted to see, because I think I want to review vowels a little bit more. Because I think that's normally what happens, is that people recognize the letters, but the vowels is when they sometimes. Oh, yeah. Okay. All right. Okay, so Jeremy, do you want to go over line one again?
Yeah, I can do that. Should be da, da, and then it's de.
No, it's eval.
Wait, with the dot, yeah. So it's de?
D, D.
Oh, it's just D.
Sure.
Yeah, D.
Gotcha. And then that's de. Or no, do, because it's the dot on top.
Uh-huh.
And then de, D.
No, D, uh-huh.
And then do.
The one line is
Oh, da.
Da, and then this is?
De.
The vowel is O, so it will be?
Do.
Do, right, okay. All right, so remember, so Gregory and Kate, since you guys came late last time, do you understand the sounds of the vowels now?
I'm picking up the symbols to the vowel, so the T's or the lines, ah.
Very good.
And little the little dot is dot, like the D, and then and then the dot above is O. Like.
Very good. Exactly. Kate, did you get that too? Were you able to get mm-hmm. it? Okay, perfect. All right, awesome. All right, line two. Mark, can you read line two?
Dom.
So the vowel is O, so it will be
dome.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Dam. Is that
Dam, is that right?
No.
Dame?
Remember, in Hebrew, the sounds of the vowels is ah, e, e, o, and u. So that would be dam. Very good.
Dam. Dal.
Mm-hmm.
Da. Dama.
Very good.
Da.
Mm-hmm.
And da.
Okay, very good. Three, Ashlyn.
Shida.
And the vowel here is
Shida.
Mm-hmm.
Mida.
Mm-hmm.
Mida. Or Mido.
Mm-hmm.
Doma.
Okay, very good. Ron, number four.
Dam.
Mm-hmm.
Ada. Dati. Toda. Todot.
Todot. Okay. Todot. Okay. And number five, Kelly.
So, dash, lamad, madim,
mm-hmm.
tamid, mm-hmm. tamid, and then load.
Okay, very good. And Russell?
Dod, doda, dodim, dodot.
Okay. Is there somebody that I missed? Oh, page number seven.
Dodi.
Mm-hmm.
Ali. Da. Sha. Sha. Da. Ma. Dad.
Okay. Did I get everybody, I think? Okay, all right, let's move on. Okay, so this vowel is silent. It's there, but it's not there. So it is as if, I were to put an X here, like there is nothing. So this would be d, d, sh, sh, m, m, b, b, l, l. Okay. And I recommend that you draw the lines because if you look at this, this is bat and this is also bat. It is like it's not there. It's there, but it's not there. Bat. This vowel is called shva. And shva is silent. So again, you would ask, why is it there? There are some rules of why it needs to be there. So again, it has to do with the vocalization rules. But when, for the purpose of reading, when you're reading, you just pretend as if there is no vowel. So let's say I'm going to take this word here. So this word would be lom dim. It's there, but it's not there. Lom dim. Let's look at line four. So this is silent. This is silent, this is silent, and this is silent. Now, okay, Hebrew is, what you need to do is, you look at the word, the letter, and then you look down at the vowel. And you wanna try and break it down into syllables. So the way I would break it down is I would put the break in here, and I would read it as tal mid,
Okay. Now, again, here, I would break this down like this. So I'm going to look only on this one right now. So this would be what, if I'm just looking, focusing on this, this would be what, tal. And then this would be what right here?
Me.
Me. And the last part will be?
Da.
Da, exactly. Tal, me, da. And that will make it easier to read. The more you kind of break it down for you, you look, first of all, you look up, down, up, down, up, down. That's how you read it. And then you try to break it down. And it makes the reading a lot easier. Okay, so let's look at this one right here. Do the same thing. We're going to break it here and we're going to break it here. So the first part is what? What's the first part?
Tal.
Tal and then?
Me.
And then?
Deem.
Very good. And the same thing over here.
Tal. Me. Dote.
Okay, very good. So this would be tal mid, tal mi da, tal mi dim, tal mi dot. Okay, that's how we read it. All right, any questions? Because today we went through a lot of letters and a lot of vowels. So we actually went over, if we go over here, we learned the lamed, the mem, and the dalet, and we learned the vowel a, o, and e, and silent. So we learned a lot of vowels today, okay? So I encourage you to review everything that we talked about. Let me just stop this share. All the vowels, all the letters. There will be a recording, hopefully. If, wait, I think I can go there now and show you where it is. Oh, I cannot go to that site from here. Maybe there, it's blocked in here because I don't want the kids to get into here. And let me see. Let me see if I can find it, just a second. I think that they blocked the YouTube. Okay, here. All right, so let me share this with you. If you go to Bethel Zedek YouTube channel, even you can just find it, okay? There should be, if you go down, I don't know if you can search for it. Maybe let me see if I can do more than Aleph. Let's see if it would just come up. No, sorry. These are some of the, it should come up. You have to search for them. Okay, so this is from last year. But if you look at December 12th, that means we're towards the end. So you want to go, there is 11:21, 11:14. So you want to maybe, see there is 10:10. 10:3 might have been the first one. So you want to maybe check this one out. And at least you can listen to this if you want to. Okay. We are going to post ours today. On Tuesday, the new ones, and you should be able to have access to them. But if you don't want to wait till then, you can go back and access those because they're already posted. Okay. All right.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. You're welcome. Before we go, do you have any questions? Anybody? Okay. All right. So I will see you next Sunday, okay? And I will post the videos. And I encourage you really to spend some time at home to practice some of the reading, okay? And I send you the YouTube video just to learn the letters. And there are some, again, if you check, I can send you some videos, but if you just go to YouTube videos and you can say learning Hebrew letters, there's all kinds of stuff there. But this is just for you to review it, okay? And I will see you next Sunday. Have a great day. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Bye-bye. I'll stay in here. If you have any questions, I'll hang in here.
Does she have a class on Tuesday?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I do have a question for you.
Sure.
I'm going way ahead of myself, but when we get done with this, what can we expect? I mean, to be able to read, not out of the Torah.
Yes, so you'll be able to read more fluently and have a little bit of background. I mean, if we get through the reading faster, we will have more time to go through prayers and learn the prayers and learn the meaning of the prayers. So let's say my goal is, because a lot of these students may not necessarily have a lot of background in Judaism or holidays or how the prayers or the blessings connected to stuff. So let's say maybe around Hanukkah, what I normally do, I teach people the blessings for Hanukkah, so at least they know that. You know, stuff like that. If we finish the reading, then we're going to start looking at prayers and the meaning behind the prayers and all of that. That's really the intention of the class. It's not for you to be able to speak Hebrew, because 10 sessions is not enough, but you should be able to read the prayers by the end. That's the goal.
So this is not necessarily to understand what the Hebrew words mean.
Okay, so I do teach you roots and words, but it's not, let me just pause.